this is going to be just a quick video. I went out and did a bunch of hunting around on my local want ads online and just trying to see if I can find some 18650s. And I found a huge hull. And it's, well, huge. I guess it's all relative. But it's going to be, I was able to pick up about 2,400 cells for a really good price. And I turned around and I sold some to a friend of mine, and he's doing some projects, and I'm going to share those later on. But he's been using them for some of his things, and I have kept several hundred for myself. I've sold a few to others, but for the most part, I have probably about 1,500 cells remaining that I'm processing right now. You can kind of see them back here. And I'm just going to take them and see how they turn out. Most of them are really good cells. They're brand new, and I'm having very good luck with them. So I'm just going to share with you a little bit of what happened when I went to pick them up. And I have video of as I returned home and my truck full of 18650s. It's pretty cool. So let's go take a look at that, and we'll come back and I'll show you the cells. And how they actually look individually. So let's go. I just wanted to show you a find that I did this, well, I guess it's been a little bit ago, but I found by going online and hunting down cells, it was a local classified ad, I ran across these 18650 cells that were being basically kind of discarded. And so I was able to pick up several cases of these cells, and I'm going to be processing those. I'm actually pretty excited about being able to have quite a few cells. I got a really good deal on them. Each cell has its own charge controller, which is kind of unique. So anyways, I'll talk more about that. They're all brand new. These are brand new cells. They were supposed to be part of a medical equipment project that basically got scrubbed, and so they were just trying to unload all of these 18650 cells that they were going to use for their for producing this medical equipment. So anyways, I got to be a beneficiary of some brand new cells. They're rated at about 2200 milliamps, so they have a little bit of juice. They're not, you know, awesome, they're not 3000s. There's not very many of them out there, but these here were a good price, and I'm very, very excited about them. So I just wanted to point out that if you put forth a little bit of effort, you can go and find all sorts of cool deals just by looking online and taking a little extra effort to see what you can find. So anyways, got several hundred here I'm pretty excited about. So hopefully encourage you to look locally and see if you can find cells that are brand new. You don't have to harvest them. I mean, I have to tear them apart. I gotta tear the skins off, and I still wanna do testing on them. I wanna make sure I keep my packs consistent, and I wanna look for any bad cells. But other than that, I'm pretty excited to have a whole grouping of brand new cells. So, till then, we'll talk to you later. Wanted to go over these cells. I apologize, my autofocus on my camera may kind of go all over the place, but when these cells came in, they got this this skin on them that actually it wraps them or encompasses them completely. They have these three wire leads, and what I found was, I know that the red and the black are your positive and negative, and I think the white went to the device that they were whatever they were testing on as a part of the charge controlling piece of it. So if I take and tear off this outer jacket, inside we end up with a Made in Japan by Sanyo. They are UR 18650 FJs. And they're brand new cells. They're rated at 2100 milliamps. And these charge controllers that are in here, they're more of a charge protection than anything. And I'll have some close-up photos that you can take a look at these charge units that just control the flow. I have done some testing with them and tried to see if I could get them to act as a, you know, like reverse polarity or an overcharge, and they didn't seem to do a whole lot. So I'm not 100% sure. It may have to do with this white wire and the device that it was plugging into. So a lot of this stuff here is really unnecessary for what I'm using them for. They are just spot welded into place, and it has like a little gasket here to protect it. But they're clean cells. They're brand new Sanyos, and that's exciting within itself. So when I strip those down and get the outer jackets off of them, then what I end up with is this is a cell here that I've tested, and they actually are doing really well. I was really surprised. This number over here is the resistance on the cell, and I've always just used laptop batteries, and they've always been up around 300 and 400. I think it's milliohms is what they're rated at. I'm using one of those IMAX B6 devices to actually do the checking of what the resistance is in the cell. But these here have been testing out from 200. I've even had some that are down in the 100s, so they have very low resistance. This cell itself, after being charged up to 4.2 volts, it came out at 2168 milliamps. So, that's a good cell. And then I'm also working on a process, because I like to kind of make things look pretty. You've seen my portable power pack, and this is an idea that I'm working on right now as well. This is a clear jacket, and I bought some just to see how they turn out, and I actually like that chrome look. And so I'm going to be playing some more with that, and hopefully we'll have some good video to show on the chrome pieces. So the pieces that I removed from several different cells, here's what they look like on the back side. So this is one that I've just pulled off. I'm not really sure if anybody has any ideas of what these chipsets are used for. I've Googled and I haven't been able to find anything that gives me any indication as to what they're used for, other than they seem to be a MOSFET that would help deal with like overcurrent, over voltage, or constant current, constant voltage. But I have not been able to find any details on that. So if you have any information on that, I'd love to hear about it. These two chips here are the same, and then this other one up here is different. So if you guys know what they are, be great to know. But I have literally hundreds of these. I have probably, when it's all said and done, I'm probably going to have, maybe 1,500, 1,800 of these. I can't remember how many I've done so far, and I have other battery packs that I'm tearing into as well. So anyways, I just wanted to show you the cells. They're really cool, and I'm glad that they're brand new. They're heavy, and I like that. They have weight to them. I mean, they're not overly heavy, but they're not cheap cell heavy. So we'll see how these turn out when I get them ready to start building them into a power rack. Okay, I hope the information I provided in this video was helpful. If you like what you saw, please subscribe below, and please share with your friends, and come back frequently. If you have any questions or comments about what you saw in this video, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll gladly get back to you. Thanks for watching.